The topic is intraoral radiographic technique. Intraoral radiography, it is the foundation for the dental radiography and it is also known as the backbone of the imaging for a general dentist. What are the types of intraoral radiographic techniques? So there are these three types, that is periapical, bite-wing and occlusal. In periapical, so the periapical radiography, it shows the entire tooth and its surrounding bone. The purpose of such radiography, it is to examine the entire tooth. Now, as the name suggests, periapical, so it is nothing but around the apex of the tooth. So, as the name suggests, it shows the terminal end of the root of the tooth and the surrounding bone. And basically, there are two methods for periapical radiography, that is paralleling angle technique and bisecting angle technique. Now, what is bite-wing radiography? So, bite-wing radiography, it shows the crown of the maxillary and the mandibular teeth and the adjacent crest. So its purpose, it is to examine the crowns of the maxillary and the mandibular teeth. Third one is the occlusal. Now occlusal radiography, it reveals a larger part of the tooth and the bone as compared to the periapical film, where we see the restricted area. So occlusal is nothing but it shows a larger part of the tooth when it is compared to periapical. Now starting off with the first intraoral radiographic technique, that is periapical radiography. So what are the indications of periapical radiography? So periapical radiography, it is a technique of an oral structure which is taken when you are placing this film in the oral cavity, while the X-ray source, it is outside the oral cavity. Now as we know, there are intraoral and extraoral radiographic technique. Now periapical is intraoral radiography technique. So starting off with the indication, so first indication is the apical lesions. Periapical radiography, it is very useful in detection of the apical region lesions. So whenever there are apical lesions present, in that periapical radiography is very useful. Next is dental caries. So for the detection and the evaluation of dental caries, periapical radiographic is used. The next is the mixed dental or the dentition analysis. So it is helpful in the orthodontic treatment. Next is the pulp pathology. Pulp pathology is to evaluate the pulpal calcification and pulp stone. So if there are any pulp stone or calcification which is present, periapical radiography is indicated. Next is the periodontal status. So it is useful in the assessment of the periodontal status. For example, if there is bone loss, so how severe the bone loss is. So in that case, you can use this periapical radiography. Next one is trauma. So it is useful in detecting the trauma which is associated with the tooth and the surrounding bone. So it can be used in the cases of trauma. It can be used, for example, in cases of fractures. So to detect the fracture, the class of fracture, you can use periapical radiography. Then unerupted teeth. So assessment of the presence and position of an unerupted teeth, it can be an indication for periapical radiography. Now the next one is the root morphology. Assessment of the root morphology before the extraction of the tooth. Now if your root, it is dilacerated, or if it is diverted, fused, if there is ankylosis which is present or anything, so you have to see the root morphology before the extraction of the tooth. In that case, you can use this periapical radiography. Next is the endodontic treatment. So in the endodontic treatment, so during the endodontic treatment, so to assess the working length, we are using periapical radiography. Next is apical surgery. So pre-operative assessment and post-operative appraisal of the apical surgery, it can be done with the help of a periapical radiograph. Next is the apical cyst. So detailed evaluation of the apical cyst and other lesion within the alveolar bone, it can be done with the help of periapical radiography. And the last is the implant prosthesis. So availability of the bone for implants and the evaluation of the implants post-operatively, it becomes an indication for periapical radiography. Now what are the aims of periapical radiography? First is optimal image characteristics. So it must show the image with optimum density, contrast, definition and detail. So first is you should get a proper image, that is it should have proper optimum density, contrast, definition and detail. Next is the less distortion. So it must show an image with less amount of distortion. Most distortion, they are caused by improper angulation of the X-ray beam. And the aim of periapical radiography is you should have less distortion. Then The third one is the actual image. So image, it should be of same size and shape. It should not be like enlarged, or it should not be foreshortened, and you should get an actual image. Then is the area of interest. So it should show all the tooth bearing areas with the periapical regions. So radiograph, it should show the teeth from occlusal or the incisal surface to 2 to 3 mm beyond the apices. As the periapical radiography, so as the name says, so it is beyond the periapical, so around the periapical. So in this radiography, like the radiograph, it should show the teeth from occlusal surface, and it should be 2 to 3 mm beyond the apices. It should be a simple procedure. So the procedure should be done like as swiftly as possible to minimize the patient's discomfort. So the next aim is no overlapping. There should be no overlapping in the proximal contact areas. And the last one is there should be no artifacts. So the radiograph, it should not be cracked, or it should not be bent, or it should not have any artifact. Artifacts are nothing but they are the man-made objects. So these all are the aims of the periapical radiography. Now, what are the limitations of periapical radiography? First one is trismus. Patient having difficulty in mouth opening. So the patient who have trismus, in that periapical radiography cannot be done, and it becomes a limitation of it. Next is the gagging reflex. So the patient with gagging sensation while taking the radiograph of posterior region of teeth. There are many patients who have gagging reflex. As soon as you like insert the film into their mouth, they'll just gag that out, and it becomes a limitation of periapical radiography. The next limitation is if there are large cysts and tumors present. So large cysts and tumors, it cannot be visualized completely in a periapical film, and in that case you need a panoramic or other good radiographic techniques. Next and the last limitation is two-dimensional image. So this is a major disadvantage, as we get a two-dimensional image of a three-dimensional object, and because of that we follow that projection geometry principles which I have already covered, and even object localization technique. This is the main drawback of your radiographs, that is, it is a two-dimensional image, and our tooth, it is a three-dimensional object. So this becomes a limitation of periapical radiography. Now, what are the two methods? As I said, so first is the bisecting angle technique, and the next is paneling angle technique. So bisecting is basically like this, and paneling is just when you place the film parallel to the tooth. Bisecting angle technique, it is based on the rule of isometry, and that is nothing but the Szczesny rule. So it follows the theory of Szczesny rule, and about this techniques I'm going to explain like in depth about it in my next videos, and even I'm going to cover about the other intraoral radiographic techniques that are bite wing and occlusal radiography in further videos. And that was it for this video. Thank you so much.